for points of clarification, we throw the word tone around quite liberally. He has good tone or bad tone, or your muscles are toned. You've heard that. Well, there's an element of truth to this. We've already talked about how we have all of these descending influences from our brain to our muscles. And I dare say that if we could really delve into our muscles, there's a degree of activity that's going on in these muscles. That perhaps might be equivalent to the resting tone of our muscles. We all have it. However, a pathology can create an imbalance. We can become, some people refer to as hypertonic, or have hypertone. What does that mean? That means that this subtle balance that I was talking about earlier is lost because of the location and the extent of a lesion. So some muscles, often in the case of stroke, they have this bending function, tend to be disinhibited. There are neurons firing away the patient doesn't have much control over. And there are neurons that have the opposite function of straightening out that don't seem to be as active. So the person is hypertonic with respect to motions in this position. Hyperreflexia is a precursor to what we might call spasticity. What is hyperreflexia? You know, you've all seen these reflex hammers, and you do this little tap, and we have these inputs from our tendons that have receptors or sensors in them that go into our spinal cord and come back out to the muscles and make the muscles contract. There's a normal magnitude of response we typically see in people. Some people could be hypotonic due to a variety of reasons. Yet, you tap on the tendon, you'll see hardly any movement at all. There may be reasons for that. What we tend to see mostly in neurological conditions are hypertonic responses. When you do this tendon tap, the response is exaggerated. And that's because these nerve cells, which make these muscles work, the bend in this case, the elbow, are primed to discharge because they have all these descending influences going on them. And now what we're doing with this tendon tap, we're causing some sensors to come back into the spinal cord and activate these nerve cells, these motor neurons, which are already primed to discharge, and give them a greater input, whammo, you get bigger contraction. Spasticity as a manifestation of this imbalance, where a person trying to engage who has hypertonic responses and this disconnection between the bending muscles and the extending muscles, when they try to change the length of the muscles that bend and try to straighten out, the muscles, little sensors called muscle spindles in these muscles, don't like that length change. They're very sensitive to it, and they create inputs that say, I'm going to bend again. And now you've got this input from these sensors. You're not doing this mechanically anymore. It's just the length change and trying to straighten out your elbow and lengthen these muscles, which makes these receptors discharge. They come back into the spinal cord onto these nerve cells, which govern these flexor muscles and cause them to discharge even more, resulting in a greater contraction. So the spasticity is a responsiveness, a hyper-responsiveness to sudden changes, or sometimes gradual changes, in these muscles, which are predominantly in the upper extremity flexors, and tend to be very responsive to sudden length changes.